वो ज्यादातर स्कूल में काउंसलिंग
और बैक स्टेज के स्ट्रीट सेट हुआ क्या
हाय देयर
सॉरी
सो I'm going to start with all the different organizations you've founded.
Well, good heavens, good Lord, no. No, I'll tell you before you start that. Apart from, as I tell friends, that I earn my living from the media, whereas I earn my drinks from theater.
So, how do you mean by that? You're in the theater?
No, I am actually, I used to be a director, which I gave up many years ago when I started theater criticism. I am a drama critic to the various newspapers.
So, tell me about Send It. What's Send It?
Well, Send It is an organization which has been in existence for 20 years. And I am one of its founder members and at the moment on the executive board, but the person I think you should really talk to is our director at the moment, Rajiv Jain. Mm-hmm. But basically, Send It is an organization started off, well, it is an NGO's organization, and at the moment we are concentrating a great deal on training and training particularly of women from this region. Oh. We run about 2 to 3 courses every year.
Oh. And tell me about the origins of Indian television.
Well, Indian television started as an experimental television in the 60s, early 60s. It's a pure and simple experiment research, but actually it came into its own in 1962. When it was set up as an independent center. And we started off primarily as an educational television. We were at that time telecasting to schools, that is formal education, and through teleclubs, which were programs directed to the community, which were about 3 days in a week. And educational television was every day. Gradually, as things moved on, the emphasis has completely shifted, but on paper the emphasis still remains the same, but in actuality it has become nothing more than a second-rate copy of the Indian films.
And what were your original ideals for it?
The original ideal was to be mostly education, information, and entertainment. Entertainment was low down the priorities, but now it's absolutely the reverse. Mm. And entertainment, if I may say so, of a very, very mundane kind. That is the complete thing.
Now, why is that? What makes it that way?
Pressures, commercial. We were not commercial to begin with. We now, in the Indian television, now depends a great deal on advertisement commercials. And the people who pay for it, that is the advertiser, is not interested in the things that, on paper at least, we were. That's the main thing.
Now, you were telling me that you were one of the first people that used satellite?
As you would probably remember, there was an experiment called SITE, which was Satellite Instructional Television Experiment. That was the first experiment of its kind when a geostationary satellite was used for sending out programs and for direct reception in community centers. Mm-hmm. We had a dish in each community center, and there were 300 of them in India, all in the rural areas. And programs were received there, and people watched as a community. And we had, you believe it or not, most of the time we had an audience of more than 700 to 1,000. Even if they could not hear everything, at least they could see the thing.
Do you have any photographs from those?
Well, there's a whole book. In fact, I wrote a book on how India prepared for satellite. It's published by UNESCO. And you would probably remember a gentleman who spoke in the symposium, Karnik. Well, Karnik, you see, the Indian Space Research Agency looked after the hardware. And Indian Television, that is Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, we were looking after the software. I was overall in charge because the software was our concern. The satellite belonged to NASA. They had loaned it to us for 1 year. And they were responsible for the space sector. In other words, had the satellite up in the air. As far as the software is concerned, that is the programming, that was entirely and totally the concern of the Indians. NASA had no say in the matter. And we were putting out, apart from programs in the evening in six different languages, we were also putting out programs for educational programs for primary school children in the villages. All the centers were in the rural areas.
What do you think we should do about the state of communication in the world today?
Number one, I very strongly feel that, as you have done, for instance, I don't know how you managed to get time on the cable network, but using the satellite. I presume you use the satellite to get the signal down into the cable centers.
Yeah.
And what I am rather surprised is that the cable people have given you time.
They have to, it's the law.
Well, I would very much advocate the same kind of a law to be enacted in India. We are at the moment thinking in terms of legislating about cable distribution. And I think one of the things that we must have is a law in which they must give time to, people who are interested in public utility broadcasting.
And what do you think of the Star TV and the like?
Well, the Star, to my mind, see, this is an invasion, which is going to be now a global invasion. And may I put it in this way? It is a global invasion from the West. Because the point is, because of the past associations with Western culture, Western culture not in the best of terms, but as we take it today, and the English language, in the countries which were dominated by this influence, they sort of are going to be very much influenced by this invasion. The programs, for instance, supposing it is from India or Indonesia or anywhere else, they are going to be of no interest in Europe, to my mind. It is going to be the programs from the West which are going to be directed to the Eastern countries. Now take, for instance, that, as you said, Star Television or things. What are the kind of culture that they're propagating? I'm not against good fun and so on and so forth, but it completely cuts into the roots in these countries. Yes. And it's particularly so amongst the middle classes, may I put it, and the urban middle classes. But I think the time is not far. For instance, I have a feeling that people like Murdock, who's going to now be concentrating a great deal on the local language. The language may be local, but the contents, I'm afraid, I'm talking of the entertainment programs, are going to be totally alien to the local culture. And when that comes about, and which is going to my mind, I don't give it more than a year. It is so bad, it's going to happen within this year. And it is going to have its spread in the rural communities. And that is going to be terrible. I'll give you a very small example. When television started, or even when the films, now what happens? A film star sets the fashion of a particular shirt, the collar design, and so on and so forth. Now, the manufacturers of shirts copy that with very, very cheap material, and they start selling them in the rural areas. The youth in the rural areas who've seen a particular film and seen a particular film star wear that kind of a shirt goes and buys that shirt. The material is so bad that it doesn't last more than 3 washes.
Oh, boy. And then they have to go out and buy another shirt.
Now, that is the kind of a thing. It helps them. It's again creates a consumer society. You can buy more shirts. But this is the kind of an influence that I think even from the space is going to come into the rural areas. And mind you, as the people sponsoring the MTV programs, that they say that they have edited the programs to put out for India. And if that is the edited version, God help what the original was. So I would suggest, if we in India can start something like Deep Dish, there's nothing like it. And in the meanwhile, I would say to the viewers who have access to Deep Dish, well, keep on watching Deep Dish.
Hey!